Now, there's an effect in After Effects that I love and a lot of people use. It's called the wiggle function, and it basically takes a pretty stable sort of shot and gives it camera movement in post. Now, many people use this for action shots or horror movies, whatever. It was difficult to find in FCPx. In fact, it doesn't have it at all. And because at the moment it's difficult to round trip from FCPx to motion, there's a way of building this function from motion into a filter. So I've made it here. So here I'll just show you a fairly sort of stable shot. But I want to add some sense of instability here. So I'll just add this filter that I've just created called Wriggle. And let's just play it. And as you can see, there's camera movement added. Okay, it's pretty subtle at the moment, but you can change a whole lot of things. Like, for example, I can make have a whole lot more camera movement. So I can play that back. So you can see it's a lot larger, the movement. And you can also increase the frequency, wiggle. Noise makes it a lot sharper. That's way too much, but you might love to use something like this for an action piece. And of course you can generate the randomness and change other things like the start offset and end offset. Of course, because of the movement, you might actually have to scale the clip a little bit so that you don't see any black around the clip. I'm going to show you how to do this. So let's just open motion. All you have to do is open a new motion project and create a Final Cut effect. Double click on that. Now just go over to Inspector, go to Properties, and where it says Position X and Y, just click on this little arrow here and go Add Parameter Behavior. So we want to add randomize. Yeah. Okay, and now just sort of change these functions a little bit to where you'd like the defaults to be roughly. So frequency, I might not so much. Okay, let's just have a look at that. Just play that. There, you can see it's sort of moving around fairly well. Maybe less. As you can see, I can add or subtract the amount of movement. There you go. That looks pretty good. Now, to publish these parameters through to Final Cut so that you can actually edit them in Final Cut, you have to go Publish. So you kind of click on this little arrow, and then I'm publishing pretty much everything because I want to have fine control. Okay, and all you do after that is go up to File, Save As, and name it. I name it Wriggle, or you can name it Wiggle, which is what it's called in After Effects, and just save. I've already saved it as Wriggle, so I'm replacing it now. Now, when you go to Final Cut, the filter's right there, and you can change it however you like. Already got it there, so that's two wriggles. Let me cut that. And you can change it how you like. Now, I found that if you wanted slightly more coarse movement, you should change the apply mode to add and subtract. So you'll get, oh, that's way too much noise. So maybe down here, it's smoother but larger, coarser movements. There you go. And there you have it, the wiggle function in FCPx.
Monkey see, monkey like, monkey do. Banana Mama TV.